ROEST is a super advanced, award-winning sample roasting machine packed with sensors that gives you an incredible consistency, roast over roast, but also a very productive workflow, especially if you do sample roasting. And this is why we are going to have a close look at this machine in this video. I'm Ingo from ROEST Rebels, and next to me is the ROEST L100 Plus Sample Roaster. There are three different versions from ROEST, and the main difference are the built-in sensors, and related to that also some functions. But before we start, let's have a look at for whom this machine then actually is. It is a perfect machine for small amounts of coffee, so it's really popular as a sample roaster for the evaluation of green coffee, for the quality control of green coffee. Therefore, coffee traders really like this machine, or it's also popular with roasteries that evaluate green coffee for purchasing, but also that use the machine to support them developing roasting profiles for the production roaster. In addition to that, it's also very popular in the competition scene, where people get small amounts of a lot for their competition, and then they want to roast these lots to a really good standard. And in addition to that, there are also some home roasters who like this machine, especially if they like this precision and playing around with curves, and if they're really then detail focused, this is a really nice machine for you. It's a convection-based coffee roasting machine, so it's working with the hot airflow. And this hot air is streaming through the roasting chamber. The roasting chamber is a round chamber around this dryer here. And in this roasting chamber, there are then also plates that are continuously moving the beans so that they're then always exposed nicely to the airflow. The airflow is going through the chamber and is being heated by a heating element when they're entering the chamber. At the exit of the chamber, there is then a separator which puts the chaffs in here and then leads the exhaust air at the back of the roasting machine out through a little tube. The capacity of the machine is 50 to 120 grams. Or if you have a machine with an inlet temperature sensor, and we're going to talk about the sensor quite in a minute, then you have the possibility to go up to 200 gram. And what's really nice about this machine is that you have the possibility to roast 10 batches of samples per hour. So it gives you a really high productivity to roast a lot of samples if you need to. The machine is quite compact and it weighs 14 kilo if you have the version with the wooden sides, or 16 kilos if you have the version here with these black aluminium sides. You can just use it at any common electricity socket. It takes 230 volts and around 1615 watts as a maximum, so about the same as a hairdryer, so you can just plug it in anywhere where you are. The control options in this machine are, on one hand, the temperature of the airflow, so the strength of the heating element that is heating the air, then also the strength of the airflow itself, how fast it's going through your machine, and then also the velocity of the blades that are moving your beans in the roasting chamber. But now let's go into what makes this machine special, and these are the sensors that are built in. I'm going to explain you the sensors based on this machine, on the L100 Plus. If you want to see the difference between the three machines, then go to our website where you see the S100 and S100 Plus as well. You find the link down there. So it has five sensors that are only to measure the temperature. There are three sensors in the roasting chamber. One is a classic beam probe. The beam probe is the most common way of measuring the temperature during the roasting process, and it's also the one that is the easiest to compare with other roasting systems. In addition to that, it has a little bit higher an air temperature sensor, which is measuring the temperature of the air in your roasting chamber in order to get an idea of the thermodynamics that is happening in the roasting chamber. There is also a third sensor, as I told you, in the roasting chamber, and this one is measuring then the temperature that is getting out of the machine. So it's the exhaust temperature sensor. And on the other side of the exhaust temperature sensor, there is the inlet temperature sensor, a sensor that is actually quite popular with roasters because it gives you a very good idea of the heat that is getting into the roasting chamber. So this sensor is then measuring how hot the temperature is that is getting into your roasting chamber, and it's a really nice way of optimizing your roasting process. And last but not least, there is then also another sensor which is measuring the temperature of the surface of your drum so that you know how hot the roasting drum is where the beans are being moved in. But there are even more sensors, and one, and this is one that I particularly like, is a first crack detection sensor. So it's a microphone that measures the first cracks that are happening and then directly marks the first crack in the profile. And directly related to this sensor is then an adaptive profile system that then changes the profile in a way that you always have either the same development time or the same development time ratio, no matter how you have set up the profiles. And there is one sensor up here. This is actually then the beam inlet. So there is a sensor that is measuring if you're opening the door here and if you're putting in the beans in your roasting chamber so that it knows when to start the roast. And there is also another sensor here that is checking if you have the cooling tray installed or if it's not installed in your machine. If you want to visually see what's happening in your roasting chamber, you have here a nice window with a beautiful light. The light is now off, but when you're in the roasting process and the beans are in the roasting chamber, then you will see a really nice light in the roasting chamber so that you can beautifully see the bean surface color, as well as also here when the beans are out of the roaster, you have a beautiful light and then you can really nicely evaluate the color of the surface of your beans, as well as a dryer here to take out some beans during the roasting process. Of course, for all that you need a software, and ROEST has a beautiful software that is cloud-based. You connect your machine with this little antenna here to Wi-Fi, and then you can actually access the web portal with any device. So you can use it on a tablet or on a computer, whatever you prefer, and then directly control or monitor the rows during the process. The software is really nice. You have the option to compare different rows. You have the option to make a roast into a profile, to change profiles, of course. But you have also a library of more than 250 roast and profiles that have been developed by some really nice roasters that you can then directly put on your machine and do a roast based on this. You have also an inventory function and a cupping function so that you can evaluate how the beans are and then link that to a profile in order to improve your profiles or know which one is the best for which bean. The way you control your rows is PID based. So you take one of the sensors, you decide for one sensor, you draw a roasting profile there, and then the machine is working its way along this roasting profile. One thing that's also nice about this version of the ROEST is that it has a between the batch protocol. So this is not only a roasting profile, it's then a particular roasting profile that leads you from the end of one roast to the beginning of the next roast. And that then secures that you have the same temperature, but also the same momentum when you're starting the next roast, so that you get a really nice consistency roast over roast. The maintenance of the machine is really simple. What you do regularly is taking out the chaffs here. You have a little drawer that can take about 20 roasts. You then also have a chaff filter here at the cooling tray, which you regularly clean. And then one thing you do from time to time is you're taking out those four screws, are opening the cover, and then hoover the machine here where the beans are being let in, as well as at the backside where the air is being let into the system. And then after about 1,000 rows, you have a bit a larger maintenance procedure where you disassemble the machine and then especially take out the fans and clean the fans. This is a procedure that is really well described in a video that ROEST made. Actually, ROEST has a really nice database of information and videos about how to work with the machine that's super beautifully done by the ROEST team. As any roasting machine, there is smoke being produced during the roasting process. It's not too much with this machine because the amount of smoke is always correlated to the amount of beans you have in the roasting process. And here you have quite small amount of beans, but nevertheless, there is some smoke. And the whole smoke is being let out at the back at one hole. And here you can mount, for example, a tube like I have here, or you have also the possibility to take such an L profile or such a 90 degrees elbow that you can put on the machine if you're roasting, for example, below a kitchen vent. But now let's have a look at what I particularly like about this machine, but also about things that you need to know before you buy this machine. What I particularly like about this machine is its consistency with all the sensors that it's giving you, with all the precise information. You can choose the sensors that you like most, that gives you the most value, but you also have the possibility of a between the batch protocol so that you get then really roast after roast a nice consistency here. What I like about this machine is this fully automated roast. So just put in the beans, tear here so that the roast is started. It does the whole roast. It measures the first crack. It sets then the precise development time or development time ratio based on the first crack that you have marked, and then ends the roast at the point where you have defined it. Of course, if you like that, you can also do a fully manual roasting on this machine. But nevertheless, you have the possibility to not only do a fully manual roast, but also intervene in an automated roast and then change any setting that you like. For example, if you typically have a flick and crash in a profile and you want to do some changes here, you can intervene in the roast. And then after that, even go back to the fully automated roast by just pressing again on the roasting profile, and then the machine is getting back to automated mode. And related to that is the extreme productivity that you have with this sample roaster. So while you're cooling the previous batch, you can already start with the new batch. And like that, you can then process about 10 samples in an hour, fully automated, which is supporting you a lot if you have to roast a lot of samples. The only thing you have to know is that it's quite heavy, between 14 and 16 kilos. You can take it for a travel, and ROEST made a really nice pelly case, which is super secure, has wheels so that you can travel with the machine. But if you really intend to have a sample roaster for traveling, then it's maybe not the perfect machine. I see it more as a sample roaster that is stationary based, for example, with a green coffee trader, with a roastery, or in a lab somewhere. Now let's do a roast together so that you can see the workflow of this machine. I've prepared 100 grams of green coffee from Honduras, have chosen a roasting profile from Tim Wendelbo for a Honduras coffee. Then I have put this lever down to preheat the machine. Now it's hot, and I'm going to charge the beans into the machine. I'm going to tear this lever now, and then the roast is going to start. Now the roast is started and the profile is working along the preset profile on the machine. And when the first crack is being reached, the machine is going to detect the first crack. Now, if you have a look at the software, then you can see here all the different sensors. You see the inlet temperature, exhaust, air, target, bean temperature, rate of rise, drum temperature. And below here also the settings. You see the fan is now with 70% working, the power setting, the RPM is how fast the beans are being turned in the roast chamber. And the yellow line here is the target that is being preset. So in this profile, it's an air temperature that is being preset. And the blue line is the one that's following this curve. And you see how beautifully they're overlaid. So the blue curve is really precisely following the yellow curve. Now you hear the cracks from the first crack, and they're all being recorded in the software also, as you can see here. The machine has now marked first crack and is now already in the development time. So it's measuring development time. We are now at 48 seconds and is now automatically dropping the roast when it has reached the target development time. Now the roast is done. The beans are being cooled down here in this little drawer, and the machine is already being prepared for the next roast. I hope this video was helpful for you and it gave you more information about the ROEST Sample Roaster. If you're interested in one of these machines, or if you want to know more about it, then come to our website or ask me anytime. You'll find my contact on roasttravels.com.